Leprechauns are small, fairy tale creatures who love treasure.
Treasure? But what do they do with it?
They hide it away, and sometimes they'll sneak it into people's homes to repair their shoes. But if they're in a bad mood, they steal them instead.
But my shoes have holes.
Leprechauns are pranksters, Lucas. Stay alert.
Greetings, Detective. A wave of mystical robberies is sweeping Dublin. St. Patrick's Day is coming, and I suspect these crimes are connected. I fear that mass panic could disrupt the festivities. We desperately need your help, Constable Thomas MacDonald.
Oh, Detective, I read about you in the newspaper. Could you bring me a cup of coffee? If you do, I promise to share the latest gossip. Have you heard about the terrible robberies around Dublin?
I've heard that shoes are among the items being taken.
I'll tell you who it is. It's the leprechauns. Their gold was stolen from them, and now they're getting revenge.
Oh, Delma! Leprechauns? Really? Whoever it is, I don't want it to happen to me. Please, stop them, Detective.
Received a letter from Constable Thomas MacDonald. He asked me to investigate Dublin's mysterious robberies. Local rumors suggest they're the work of leprechauns. I must meet the constable. He'll have more information on the robberies.
Look!
My suitcase!
Freeze!
Evening, sir. I'm Lucas. Are you really a detective? Constable McDonald was called away, so he gave me a shilling to meet you. He asked me to give you this. Someone stole your suitcase? He must still be here. There's a cue for the exit.
Excuse me. Pardon. Sorry. Thief! He stole my suitcase!
Good evening, sir. Are you chasing a short guy dressed in green? I saw him leave the train station, but he's fast. You won't catch him on foot. But I'm the fastest cab driver in the city. Only 2 pounds. What do you say?
Yeah.
Great, hop in. My name's Casey, by the way. We could ask bystanders if you had a picture of this guy. You can use my notebook. It should be on the seat. Great portrait, sir. Let's hurry.
Another dark city, my friend.
Thank you.
trail ends here, Detective. The short guy must be inside.
Hello there. My name is Gareth Foley. This little prankster is Duncan. What has he done? Wait, let me guess. He's stolen something from you. Please forgive him. He likes to take things, but it's usually just cheap trinkets. The locals are used to it. I always put people's things in the display case for them to reclaim. I hope you don't think Duncan's involved in the recent robberies. If you help me find the keys for the window, I can prove his innocence. Duncan, stop it. I'm sorry, Detective.
Come on.
I chased the leprechaun to this shoe store. The leprechaun turned out to be a monkey named Duncan. Gareth Foley convinced me that Duncan isn't involved in the string of robberies. It's high time I met the constable.
Did you catch him?
I'm glad I convinced you that Duncan isn't involved with the robberies. Hey, he returned what he took from your suitcase. I think he likes you.
How else can I help?
We'll reach the constable's office in a minute, Detective.
It looks like someone was expecting you.
Good evening, Detective. I'm Constable Thomas McDonald. Thank you for coming. I'm sorry I couldn't meet you in person. Let's take a ride and I'll brief you on the case. I've prepared the report with all the details for you.
Detective, look!
My name is Mrs. O'Farrell. I'm the mistress of this orphanage. Why are you chasing my boy? Stolen shoes? There must be some mistake. Let's discuss this inside. I think there's been a misunderstanding, Detective. These are old shoes that people donate to children for the holiday. The boy was collecting the shoes around the square. We could purchase new shoes if we had the financial support that the mayor promised us. I'm afraid the children won't talk to strangers. But you're welcome to check everything yourself.
I'm not saying nothing.
Thank you, kind stranger. Thank you.
Detective, there's been another robbery nearby. We must get to the scene.
I don't want to hold you up, gentlemen. My children are all accounted for here. So they couldn't have committed this crime. I hope these robberies won't affect the St. Patrick's Day parade. People are usually more kind to the less fortunate when they're celebrating.
This is the place, Detective. I told my boys not to touch anything until you've examined the crime scene. They found this at the entrance.
Shorty, or I'll throw another shoe. Help me, Mr. Scratchy. I'd give you some candy, but it's outside. Candy.
my shoe! Mr. Scratchy! There you are! I heard a noise, so I hid! I saw a creepy shadow with a hat looking for something. Then I stumbled and fell. Somehow I fell asleep. And when I woke up, I saw an evil little creature looking through the books. So I threw a shoe at him and hid again. Stay here alone. Okay, I'll wait for my parents at the police station.
The constable said he'd wait for you in the office. Got a lead, detective? What does your deductive method tell you? Ah, it's a pity you've learned the truth, Detective. I didn't want to have to do this. Our plan is just beginning.
Daughter, where is my daughter?
There you are, Detective. Children around the city have been kidnapped, and their parents believe it's the leprechauns getting revenge for their stolen gold. The only evidence we've found so far is this ransom note. Please have a look. Perhaps you'll find a clue we missed. Leprechauns? I just don't know. I'll report it to the mayor, but please continue the investigation. There's no time to waste.
Thank you. Thanks for your help. How can I return the favor? I've never seen toys like this before. And I don't know why it has a store tag. Perhaps my colleague Casey Gallagher decided to make some extra money on the side. He's mentioned that he wanted to leave. That must be why he attacked me when I found his diary. It must have had drawings of his new toys. I managed to take a couple of pages from it. Take them. I hope they'll prove my innocence.
Casey Gallagher pretended to be my driver and attacked me. A leprechaun toy led me to Manus Clark, the owner of a toy store. He told me that Casey Gallagher attacked him when Manus found his diary. People believe that leprechauns took the children, but perhaps Gallagher has something to do with the kidnappings. I should follow him to the orphanage to find the truth about the leprechauns and the missing children.
You, Detective? What happened? How did I get here? We were in your cab and the driver hypnotized you. I got scared and ran to the police station to tell them what happened. I found a leprechaun toy near the police station. When I picked it up, I heard bells ringing and a voice called me to come to the lighthouse. That's all that I remember. I think this all goes back to that creepy leprechaun toy that you found in my house. Thank you, Detective. I know you can figure out what happened to us. I should get home. My parents must be back now. Take this, it might help you.
Evidence at the orphanage proves that Casey Gallagher used the children to make the leprechaun legend a reality. The orphans got inside the homes of wealthy Dublin families and left his toys there. Then, when the bell rang, the toys hypnotized the children. Many children went to the lighthouse, so I must go there to save them.
He found us! Thank you for saving us. I didn't mean to start the fire. I was just scared. Please don't arrest us. Mr. Casey just wants to save the orphanage. We wanted to help him, so we pretended to be leprechauns. We weren't gonna hurt anyone. You should talk to Mr. Casey at the top of the lighthouse. Take this. It'll help you get there. Mr. Casey will explain everything, and you'll understand what we were trying to do.
So, you found us, Detective. Well, I see no reason to hide anymore. I've been behind everything. The children helped me spread panic with the legend of the leprechauns. But now, with the stakes this high, I can't let anyone get in my way. Casey, please use your toy to hypnotize Mr. Detective.
I'm sorry, Detective, but we're out of options.
Please, help Casey. He's done nothing wrong. Save him. And I'll confess everything.
Here's the truth, Detective. My pupils found the gold of the leprechauns. We planned to spend it on repairing the orphanage to make it a better place to live. As you saw, it's in terrible condition. But the mayor used threats and blackmail to take the gold for himself, leaving the orphanage in ruin. People believed in the legend of the leprechauns, so Casey and I used that to return the stolen gold. Read this letter, and you'll see that I'm telling the truth. I promise we will send all the children back home, but go to the mayor's mansion before you arrest us. You'll find the evidence and understand our decision.
Miss O'Farrell was behind the entire plot alongside Casey, her former pupil. She said that her children found the gold of the leprechauns, but Mayor Campbell took it away, leaving the orphanage in poverty. Miss O'Farrell and the orphans worked together to bring the legend of the leprechauns to life and get the gold back. According to their plan, the mayor would return the stolen treasure to the lighthouse in exchange for the missing children. Now that the children are safe, I must go to the mayor to learn the truth and recover the gold for the children.
Thank you. detective, what are you doing in my house? Are you accusing me? The gold is mine, and nobody will take it from me. Detective, I didn't take the gold from the orphanage out of greed. I did it because I'm sick, and I need this money for the treatment. My savings were not enough. I can't let you or anyone else stop me.
Mayor Campbell stole the gold from Miss O'Farrell's orphans. The mayor intended to spend the gold on his treatment, leaving the orphans in poverty. He was bankrupt and saw an opportunity to get the money another way. But Miss O'Farrell didn't back down. She decided to get back what had been stolen. And so the leprechauns arrived in Dublin and hypnotized the children of wealthy families. But did the ends justify the means? Gold was returned to the orphans, and the citizens of Dublin forgave Miss O'Farrell. All the missing children returned home safe and unharmed. The orphanage was rebuilt anew. Manus Clark gave Casey Gallagher a chance to return to work. They even donated some toys to the new orphanage. Mayor Campbell was arrested for blackmail and theft, but Miss O'Farrell eventually forgave him and helped him pay for medical care. My investigation was a success. The holiday celebrations went on, and the leprechauns remained a legend.